Hello, and welcome to today's demonstration of troubleshooting serial communications on an 880 indicator. So the first thing we're going to do is attempt to send the version command. From sending the version command, we should receive a response indicating what version of firmware the indicator is. This is often a standard for troubleshooting. We will now type V-E-R-S-I-O-N and hit carriage return, also known as enter. Since we did not get a response and we did not get two question marks indicating that the indicator received the command but could not understand it, we will now look elsewhere. We will start by checking our communications. From here I can see that I'm set up for 9600, no parity, 8 data bits, and 1 stop bit. We can also check to verify that we have the correct COM port selected. COM8 is my only COM, letting me see that I only have one available COM port. Now on the other side, we will also check the indicator. We go to setup and drop down. From here we see scale. We will now scroll over to ports and drop down again. Under COM port, we now have the trigger. This needs to be set to command in order for it to receive commands and output a response. We want to verify the baud. We verified that it was 9600 on the computer. Now we can verify it's 9600 also on the indicator. The bits as well, 8 and none, the same as the computer. Stop bits, 1 bit. Again, everything matches what's on the computer. At this point, we will scroll over and verify that response is also on. With response off, we would not get anything back after sending a command. However, since it is on, we know that we should be getting something back. At this point, we can hit the menu to save and exit. Now that we've verified that all our communications parameters are set, we want to verify our actual physical setup. At this point, I will swap two wires, pins 2 and 3 on a 9 pin, which are receive and transmit. Now that we've swapped the two pins, transmit and receive, we're going to hit enter, also known as a carriage return, to see if we can get a response from the 880 indicator. As we hit enter, you do see two question marks appear on the screen. That means we have communication, but it didn't understand the command. At this point, we will type in version. And as you can see, we get a response from the indicator. Version 3.0 of the 880 indicator. This has been a demonstration of how to troubleshoot RS-232 on the 880 indicator.